5.1 we have find out the what is the disadvantage of wrong position and which type of observation will be the correct to compare the given shapes. Now we will move forward to our study our next point, that is angles. We know the different types of angles. Now look at here, this is an angle of 30 degree measurement. Okay, it is a less than 90, that means it is an acute angle, and that you know very well. This is an exact 90 degree angle, so its name is right angle. This angle is more than 90 degree, its name is 120 degree, so it can be known as an obtuse angle. So that you know very well, when the given angle and its measurement is, if it is less than 90 degree, that means it is an acute angle. If the given angle and its measurement is correct 90 degree, that means it is a right angle. And the given measurement of a given angle is more than 90 degree, that means it is an obtuse angle. Okay, if they give us a line and they ask us what is the measurement of this line, so we know that the protractor having a one line, and we can say that this two line shows the direction 180 degree. So every line, the measurement of correct straight line is always 180 degree. So this measurement or the angle of this measurement is known as a straight angle, because this measurement forms a straight line. Dear student, this term is very important, because with the help of this term you have to study many more different new terms that you have to study in the next year. And this is a circle, and you know that every time a correct measurement of circle is 360 degrees Celsius. Sorry, it is only 360, but when we are expressing temperature, we are using Celsius, but when we are expressing measurement, you have to use only one degree, okay? 360 degree. So 360 degree angle is also known as a complete angle. So the given measurement is less than 90, that means it is an acute. If it is a correct 90 degree, that means it is a right. If given measurement is more than 90 degree, that means it is an obtuse angle. And if angle having 180 degree, that means it is a straight line, so it is known as straight angle. And circle is having 360 degree angle, so that is a complete angle. Okay, so with the help of these different measurements and different types of angles, now we are going to study a new term in the point of clock and direction. So dear student, these two points are very important. These two points are very important to give a competitive exam. Okay, so when you are going to study for the competitive exam, these two terms are mostly used in mathematics and intelligence papers. Okay, so listen it carefully, watch it carefully. Now you can see this, there are four clocks. You know that very well. Just look at the clock which that you have in your home. Okay, you can take it in your you can take the ball clock in your hand also. Please, if you have, then pause this video and take it. Okay, now look at here carefully. Our clock having 12 numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11. Okay, these 12 numbers are correctly placed on the same interval. Okay, this 12 and 1 number having 5 parts, as like this, this all 5, every 2 numbers having 5 parts will be there. Okay, as like that. Okay, now already we have studied that our circle is always measures of 360 degree. Okay, that means the measure of this whole circle or clock is also measures 360 degree, so it having a one complete angle. Okay, now you can see this all this 360 degree angle are divided into 12 parts. So when 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, that means this 360 bar is divided into 12 bar. So each bar is carrying of 30 degree angle. Okay, that means this 11 to 12 having how much degree angle? 30 degree. This 10 to 11 having 30 degree angle. This 9 to 11 having 30 degree angle. So we can say that 30 plus 30 plus 30 gives us 90. That means 3 parts having 90 degree angle. 3 parts of clock with respect to its center, it having 90 degree angle. Okay, now this 12 to 1 is also 30 degree. This 1 to 2 is also 30 degree. And this 2 to 3 is also 30 degree. That means total 6 parts will carry 3, 6 are 80. Now I will write here that one part of clock, one part carry 30 degree angle. I said that 3 parts 30 into 3, that is 90 degree. 6 parts 30 into 6, that is 180 degree. 9 parts 30 into 9, it is 270 degree. Okay, how many parts are there? 6 parts are there. So 12 parts are there. So out of this 12 parts, if we are considering 6 parts, that means it is a half part. Okay, this 12 parts, now we will consider it is a one revolution. Okay, if it is considered 6 parts, that means it is a half revolution. Okay, 3 parts, that means 1/4 revolution. Half of half, that means 1/4 revolution. And if it is considered 9 parts, that means 3/4 revolution. Okay, now how we can understand about this 1/4, half and 3/4 revolution. Now look at here, I will draw here one circle and I will convert it into clock. This is a 3, this is a 9, this is 12 and this is 6. 4, 5, 7, 8, 10, 11, 12 and 2. Now look at here. Okay. Now we have to study about how we can say 1 revolution, half revolution, 1/4 revolution and 3/4 revolution. If it is considering total circles, that means one circle is will be considered 1 revolution. Okay, now look at here in this figure, from 12 to 12, okay. That means if from 12 to 12, it will cover one total circle, okay. That means it is a one revolution. Okay. It completes the circle, so it is a one revolution. Now look at here. From 12 to 6. Okay, from 12 to 6, it completes only half circle. That means half revolution. Okay, now in this figure you can see this from 12 to 9. Okay, so out of this, now look at here, if you consider there are 4 parts, from 12 to 3, 3 to 6, 6 to 9 and 9 to 12. And the given timing is here from 12 to 9. So 12 to 9, that means out of 4 parts it covers only 3 parts. So we will write here 3/4 revolution. Okay, and from 10 to 1, now look at here, from 10 to 1, how we can say that how many parts is covering this diagram? Now look at here, already we have told, this clock is divided into 12 parts and out of this one part is 30 degree. Okay, how many parts they are covering? 1, 2 and 3, 3 parts are covering, okay. And each part is of 30 degree, that means 30 degree into 3, that is 90 degree. Okay, and 90 degree is only one part, okay, one This is one part, mandible. Okay. So this covers only one part from four out of four parts. So we will write here 1/4 deglutition. So now we are students. Now listen that in one complete circle, that means one deglutition. Half circle, that means half deglutition. If it is covering three parts out of the four parts, that means 3/4 deglutition. And if it is complete one part out of four parts, that is a 1/4 deglutition. Okay, this is explained in the term of deglutition. Now we will explain this in terms of its measurement. Okay, now in one deglutition, how many it completes one circle, and one circle having 360 degree. Okay, 360. Now look at here. Okay, if I parts in four parts, this is a one, this is a second, this is third and fourth. How many parts are there? Four parts. That means it is a four right angle. And we know that all these angle, all these numbers are exactly opposite their sides. So when we are comparing or when we are joining these numbers, we get the same or straight line angle of right angles. Now we can get how many right angles is complete? Okay, only two, one and two. So we will write here two right angle. It completes two right angles. In this is the first, second, and this one third. Only three. So I will write here three right angle. And now we can see this, there are three parts, that means it covers 90 degree, already we have added, that means it is here, one right angle. So by using number of parts, we can express these terms in terms of revolution and in terms of numbers of right angles. Okay, so this is very important in the point of your this exam and for other competitive exams also. Now look at here. Now we are going to study these same terms in point of view their directions. We know that east, west, north and south, these are our four important and main directions. Now without wasting our time, we will start to study. Now look at here. In this diagram, you can see east, west, north, south. If I face towards the north, and if again I have to take a turn, and I have to move again towards north. So I have to take one complete revolution. Okay. So I will take it as from my right hand side also, and from my left hand side. Okay. Now look at here. If I am facing this north side, I have to move and come. I have to come again at to the north side. I will turn to my right hand side like this way. Okay. Now, if I have to turn from the left hand side, I will turn as like this way. Is it right? But now look, it is here. If I am going to start move like this way, that means we have to blow clockwise. And if I am moving from the opposite side, that means clockwise. So how many parts are
my complete here half revolution. So clockwise half revolution, and it's complete covers two right angles. Okay, and in this diagram I just move from north to the east, but clockwise. So clockwise here one fourth revolution. Okay, because it covers only one part out of the four parts, and it covers only one right angle. Okay, now all these are clockwise direction, but if I use opposite arrow, then I have to write here anti-clockwise. Okay, so while solving a problem on these two terms or related to these terms, you have to mention it is clockwise or anti-clockwise, how many revolution it is completed, and how many numbers of right angles they are acquired by term. Okay, so with the help of this information, in the next session we will solve exercise 5.2. Till then, have a good day.